This is Tepoztlan, and that is the mountain, Tepozteco. And today is December 29th, it's a Wednesday. It'll be my last hike of the year. This will be my 31st hike of the year of 2021, which is quite a lot. That's better than once every 2 weeks. That's about maybe every 11 or 12 days. That's pretty good to average one hike every 11 or 12 days for a whole year. It's pretty good. So I'm walking through the town now. I'm by myself today. Eric is off. He's on vacation, so I'm doing this hike solo, which I've done many times. And I'm going to do, I've done this so many times. I've said that there are different sections. The first section I'm going to go to is called Los Corredores del Viento. And then I'm going to go to a place above Los Corredores del Viento. I have no idea what it's called. And then I come back down here to the town briefly, just to go back up a different path, which would go to the pyramid, which has been closed for a couple of years now. And then I'm going to go above the pyramid to, I think that's Cerro de la Luz. So that's my plan for today. This is, I've done this, I think, over 50 times. I've done this hike or different parts of this hike at different times, around 50 times, maybe more. So I'm almost at the trail. I'll be at the trail in about, in my time, about 10 minutes. And this is where I'm going. gonna try to do this next stretch all in one take. No breaks, no stopping. We'll see how it goes. Seems I always make a mistake. Around here, I always go one way and I should have gone the other way. Did I make the mistake this time? I think I'm good. I'm gonna make a slight adjustment. think I'm ready. Wait, let me adjust that just a little bit. All right. Every time I do that, I go high when I should go low. It's more natural to go up where the trail goes. I have to go through here. Thicker. And here I am at my next destination. That was 15 and a half minutes. I'll go out here to the catwalk. Yeah, on the catwalk. There we go. There's Tepoztlán. And so now I go back down to where I started. I've said this, I say this every time, but I'll say it for anybody who's watching, which I know isn't anybody, but at least for my own use, I go back to the start of the trail where I started in the village where they sell the quesadillas and food. And then I have to go up kind of parallel to where I went now, but over that way, and I'm gonna end up being up there. A little change in plans. As you can see, I'm not continuing the hike. I should be going that way to go up the mountain, but there are just way too many people. It's Christmas holiday, and even though today is a Wednesday, which would normally be very, very quiet because it's Christmas, there's a lot of people. There are fewer people here than back there. And I've said for years, I hate doing Tepozteco. The trail, when it's crowded like this, is just terrible. It's very unenjoyable. You get people who have never, it's like they've never been out of their house before, never been in nature. They're drunk, they're drinking, they're throwing garbage, they're loud, yelling, playing loud music and speakers. They have speakers in their backpacks. Some people are really, really slow, which is understandable because it's strenuous. Some people run, which is also annoying. So what I'm going to do is I'm walking away from my target, which is back here. I'm going to walk back to the car. I'm going to drive to, there's a road called Calle de los Conejos. It goes off of a road. The road goes up the mountain to San Juan Tlacotenco. And it walks through the forest, so this is actually going to take me quite a bit longer, but I think much more enjoyable. So I'm just walking to the car now. and I guess it's probably be a 20-minute drive, and I'll just park on the side of the road, and I'll walk through the forest of in Calle de los Conejos, and I'll eventually meet up with where I would have. There's some nopales. With where I would have been had I gone up the normal Tepozteca way. This is way too crowded. This is nice if you're just here for the day, but if you're here to go up Tepozteca, this is very unenjoyable. A lot of people today. So next stop is in the forest, I think. So this is the Calle de los Conejos that I mentioned, that I drove here. It took me 20 minutes to drive here. There's the car, and this is on a really steep hill that goes up the mountain. San Juan Tlacotenco is that way, and Tepoztlan is this way, and the forest is this way. And there's always a lot of dogs in here. So it was a 20-minute drive, but 15 of that I would have driven anyway. You gonna follow me? 15 of that I would have done anyway if I had done my original plan. So that's it. So let's see how long this is gonna take me. Just a second. We'll see how long this takes me. So I avoided Tepozteca, which I'm very happy about. And this is a nice walk through the forest, and I'll end up being where I was shortly. I don't know what these are. These are some cabins or huts. Not sure what they're for. I've walked on here a few times. I often come back this way when I've done this hike so many times in the past. I go up to the top, and then instead of going down Tepozteca Mountain, I come down this way and take a bus back to Tepoztlan, back to the car. I think this is only the second time that I've started here. So I'm already pretty much in the forest. I'm at the junction now. This is where I would have come up. This took me just like 13, 14 minutes to get here. If I'd come up the trail from the Tepozteca trail that everybody takes, and then you take an off trail, I would have come up from here, which takes about 30, 35 minutes. So that saved me maybe 20 minutes. So normally, as I said, I come up from there, but this time I came up from this direction, came from here, and I'm gonna continue here. So this is all very familiar to me now. This part I've done, maybe 20 times, something like that. So easy going from here. This is the very thick forest that I just walked through. It took 27 minutes to get to this point. And I'm almost at the main point. Another 3 or 4 minute walk from here. But this is kind of a view of Tepoztlán. Nice here. Back at the car now at the Calle de los Conejos. I just came from the path here, and that was, let's see, an hour and 36 minutes up and back. Very quick. I think I didn't mention, but I checked the time it took to when I parked here to where I walked to the La Cima, to the top. Took, I think it was like 32 minutes or something. Very, very quick. And I spent, I don't know how long up there, half an hour or so. So very quick. This was, this might be my new way when I do this classic. I call this El Clásico. This is the hike that I've done so many times. I might do it again this way. I like avoiding Tepozteco. It's a short drive. Much easier walk and more enjoyable to walk through the forest than to walk through all these people that inhabit or infest Tepozteco, which I really don't like. So this was much more enjoyable, very quiet. So that's it, my last hike of the year, 2021. I had 31 hikes, pretty good. That's one every, as I said, 11 or 12 days, something like that. So I don't like talking to people directly on the camera. I feel stupid. There's nobody around me, and there's probably nobody watching, so who am I talking to? But I will be back to a normal hiking schedule, maybe even next Monday, maybe on, what's that, January 3rd, I think. Maybe Eric and I will do a hike. And then, whatever. I don't know what to say. I better get off the road. There's traffic coming from both ways. Yes, that's all.